In this video, I'm going to show you how to create this pretty cool text reveal animation inside Adobe After Effects. Let's dive in.
3, 2, 1.
Before we dive into today's tutorial, I do want to mention that if you are a patron on my Patreon page, you can download the MoGurt file for Premiere Pro with this text reveal graphic. It will be linked down in the video description. But let's see how to create this from scratch inside Adobe After Effects. And just to show you once again, this is what we'll be creating here today. So it animates at the bottom left-hand corner. A line comes in, reveals the text, and then for the out animation, the text dips down underneath the line and the line goes away. All right, so to get started, what I'm gonna do is go up to Composition, New Composition. I'm gonna name this line reveal graphic. And then from the preset, I'm gonna choose 4K at 29 frames a second, but you can choose whichever resolution and frame rate you wish. And then for the duration, I'm gonna leave it at 10 seconds. Then I'm gonna click OK. All right, so the first thing we have to do is create our text. So I'm gonna grab our type tool and then click out once in our composition panel. And then I'm gonna type out our text. So in this case, text reveal. Once we have that, you can change the font and the color if you wish. I'm using Open Sans and font size looks pretty good for me. I'm gonna grab my selection tool. I'm just gonna position this at the bottom left-hand corner. Right around there is good. Next, we're going to create our line. So to create our line, I'm going to grab the pen tool. And then from the top options, I'm going to click on fill and disable the fill. So you don't want to make a fill when we draw out using the pen tool. And then we want to enable stroke. So I'm going to click on the stroke button and click on solid color and click OK. For the stroke width, I'm going to leave it at 20 pixels. That's how wide I want my stroke to be. And next, what I'm going to do is just click out once to make our first point, hold down shift to create a perfect straight line, and then click again to make a point. And once you let go, you'll notice that you have a line drawn here. I'm gonna rename this layer by clicking on it and hitting return. I'm gonna just name this line. I'm also gonna reposition this to the end area where the line is gonna be underneath the text. So I'm gonna grab my selection tool and then just move this down underneath the text. So this is essentially how it's gonna look once it's revealed. You want to make sure you're in your final resting spot before you start animating it. So once you have your text and line looking like this, the next step is to animate it. I'm going to first animate the line. So to do that, I'm going to go forward out in my timeline to around 2 seconds. And then I'm going to click on my line layer and click P to bring up position. You'll notice that the X and Y position is already separate for me. But if you need to separate them, you can always right click on the parameter and go to separate dimensions. This will enable us just to work on the Y position. So I'm gonna toggle the animation for the Y position by clicking on the stopwatch, and then I'm gonna go back to 1 second, and then just push this up above the text. Right around there is good. And we can add some easy ease to these keyframes. So I'm gonna right click on the first keyframe, go to keyframe assistant, and easy ease out. And then right click on the last keyframe, go to keyframe assistant, easy ease in. And we can fine tune the animation by going into our graph editor. So when we click on this button, we can click on the parameter and we can click on our keyframes. And while holding down shift, we can click and drag out these handlebars to get a more smooth animation. And when we click and play this back, you can see what we have. All right, now that that's done, we can exit out of the graph editor. And next we have to animate the line on. And to do that, I'm gonna add a trim paths. So I'm gonna click on our line. I'm gonna twirl up and twirl down again, and you should see this add button at the top right corner. When we click on it, you can go to trim paths. This will add a trim path to the shape layer. And if we twirl down, you'll see the end parameter. What we want to do is keyframe it, so I'm going to keyframe the end, go to the beginning, and change this down to 0. And same thing, we can add some easy ease to the last keyframe here. So I'm going to right click on that, go to easy ease in. And once again, go to the graph editor, and you can click while holding down shift on the handlebar and drag it to the left to add some curve smoothness to this animation. So once we play this back, you should see what we have. So now that we have our line animated, the next part is to make our text reveal. So to do that, we're going to create a track mat. So to create a track mat, what I'm going to do is grab our rectangle tool. And for this, I'm going to enable fill. So I'm going to click on fill, click on solid color, click OK. And disable stroke, so I'm gonna click on stroke and click on the hash and click OK. Go out to around 2 seconds in your playhead here. Make sure you're at the end of the animation. And next, just click and draw out a shape over where the text is. But make sure it's above the line. Once you have that, you can let go. I'm gonna rename the shape layer text mat And now to make this a track mat, what I'm gonna do is click on our text reveal layer, and then you should see these options right here, the pick whip tool and this drop down underneath the track mat column. If you don't see this column, you can always click on this button, toggle switches and modes, and this will switch it over. You can also click on this button down here at the bottom left-hand corner to display all of your switches and modes. But what I'm gonna do is drag this pick whip tool to the text mat. And this will essentially put this text layer inside this shape layer's alpha mat or alpha channel. In other words, its opacity. And then lastly here, what we have to do is parent pick whip this track mat to the line. So as it animates down, as the line animates down, the shape layer follows it and it reveals the text. So to do that, I'm gonna click and drag out this pick whip tool to the line, that way it follows it. So when we play this back, you can see as the line animates down, the shape follows it and it reveals the text because the text is only visible inside that shape. So that's how you can create that trick here inside Adobe After Effects. All right, so now that we have our intro animation created, we can work on our outro animation. So I'm gonna go out to around 8 seconds. And then click on our text layer. We can click P to bring up position. And I'm gonna click on the stopwatch next to Y position. And we can go out to 9 seconds. And then I'm just gonna drag this down. So it goes underneath the line. And once again, we can right click on our keyframe and go to Easy Ease Out. So we're easing out of that keyframe. I'm gonna go to the graph editor and click and drag out while holding down Shift to the right to smooth this animation out. There we go. Gonna go out of the graph editor. And lastly, we can animate the line off. So I'm gonna go out to around 9 seconds. And we can click on our end parameter, add a keyframe, go to the end around 10 seconds, and change the end to 0. And once again, we can easy ease out of this last keyframe here by right-clicking and going to easy ease out. And lastly, go to the graph editor and click and drag this handlebar out. So after doing that, this is what we have. And that's how to create this text animation inside Adobe After Effects. If you want to learn more about After Effects, there's several tutorials on my channel. I'll link one video that you might like right up there. But that does it for this video. If you have any questions, feel free to leave them down in the comments section below. But we'll see you guys in the next video. Take care.